Ah, good evening, traveler. Welcome to the Penumbra. May I take your coat? You've picked an excellent place to spend the night, dear traveler. The Penumbra is the grandest hotel this side of nowhere. Countless rooms and countless halls. Just look ahead of you. See the doors go on and on. Even we aren't sure how many there are, or what lies behind them all. Will you be staying long? Many of our guests do. You're in good company, traveler. The Penumbra draws guests from everywhere and every when, and all of them have stories to tell. Stories that will excite you, delight you, and maybe even terrify you. Don't believe me? Well, see for yourself. It's Detective Steele's day off today, and it seems he's met up with some old friends of his, the kind he might share the good old days with, were there any such days to share. Instead of fond memories, the three share a terrible secret, one they buried together 25 years ago. But secrets never stay buried forever, and when the worst of them unearth themselves, the results can be deadly. What luck! It sounds like he's in. Come, traveler. Come with me into room J14. Juno Steel and the Day That Wouldn't Die.
I hear every city's got a place like Old Town, and Hyperion City is no different. Old Town was terminal, infected by so much crime and poverty that Hyperion decided long ago that the only thing to be done was to keep it comfortable until it passed quietly. My name's Juno Steel. I'm a private eye, and this is the neighborhood where I grew up. What do you want, Rita?
Enjoying your day off, Mr. Steele?
It was until a few seconds ago.
Grouchy. What's got you so on edge?
I didn't check the address on the place Mick picked out until after I left.
Old Town, huh? Didn't you used to live there?
I wouldn't call it living.
Well, all that's real exciting, boss. Anyway, I was calling to tell you a few of the news alerts you had going just pinged.
Really?
Really. You wanted to know if any other ancient Martian stuff popped up, right? Well, just this morning, the chair of Archituthis went
It's the
went
throne
missing.
Of Archituthis, Rita.
That guy, sure. Remember how Samantha Cartwright had it in her private collection? Well, the chair's not with Sammy anymore.
She sold it.
Nope, she died.
She what?
It's quite a story. See, the HCPD thinks Samantha's business rival Mallory Park killed her, seeing as they had that whole blow-up about the throne last year. Only, the HCPD had been looking all over, and nobody can find Mallory Park.
No. She can't be dead. It wasn't supposed to happen this quickly. God damn it. Damn it!
Mr. Steele? Still there?
Alright, we'll just have to follow the leads we have. Rita, I want you to find a way into Lillian Strauss's files.
The researcher who was working on that Martian pill?
Do you know a lot of Lillian Strauss's? Don't even bother to copy them, just wipe them. If her computers aren't on any networks, I want you to break into her apartment.
Mr. Steele?
Unless the HCPD's finished their investigation. Rita, the HCPD might have all their drives. We need to...
Boss, I don't think I'm gonna get anything off of Dr. Strauss's computers.
You'd better. What the hell do you think I pay you for?
That was the other thing I called to tell you about. Dr. Strauss's apartment complex burned to the ground this morning.
Oh, of course it did.
Well, at least the drives are wiped, right, boss? I hear fire's pretty good at that.
Just because the apartment's wiped doesn't mean the drives are. I guarantee you someone out there still has them.
You want me to look around?
No, don't bother. That's it, then.
Well, sounds like a pretty bad sandstorm's gonna hit this afternoon. You probably want to be out of Old Town by then. The shield over there is about as strong as used tissues. They went into lockdown 3 times just last month.
Just my luck. Thanks, Rita. That was helpful. Hang on, where did you get this report from?
Oh, it was a special report. Came on the stream while I was watching this marathon of Martian Medical.
You're watching your shows in the office?
Oh, come on, boss. It's my day off.
It's not, actually. It's my day off.
Well,
just let me know if anything else goes wrong, all right?
Aren't you forgetting the magic word?
I am not going to say please, just so you'll do your job.
Well, I ain't gonna work under conditions so antagonistic, Mr. Steele. I got a very delicate constitution.
is.
Sure, boss. Have fun with your friend.
I was late to the bar. I had to take a detour to avoid the house I grew up in. Should have just kept detouring straight out of Old Town.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. The pouring floor, that can't be right.
Hey, Jay. JJ, is that you, buddy?
Just keep driving, Steel. Come on, just keep driving.
Hey, Jay, nice ride, buddy. Pretty bad. Chromed upholstery, plastic windows, a steering wheel? This thing new?
It was once, about a decade ago. That's not chrome, Mick, it's tape.
Cool, cool. Hey, can I park this? Always wanted to drive me one of these.
A car?
Yeah.
I think I've got this under control.
Suit yourself. Not every day you're getting offered to ride side by side with Mick Mercury. King of the freeway.
King of the freeway. Mick got that nickname back when we were kids. He got an old junked up hover cycle from his drug dealer uncle, and that made him the only kid in our neighborhood that had ever been outside of Old Town. Or so he said. Because that's the thing about Bartholomew Mick, King of the Freeway Mercury. He'd never actually been on the freeway. Just made up stories about the other parts of Hyperion to impress us. Kids came from blocks around just to hear those stories, until the day his lies caught up with him. Told us he spent the day doing donuts on the roof of the Apex building, only for the 10 o'clock news to say he'd been bombed to powder that morning. Then all the kids stopped coming. All of them except for me and Sasha, anyway.
Remember why they call this place the pouring floor?
Because they pour until
you hit the floor. Mm-hmm. Pretty good, right? That used to kill when we were kids. Hey, what's wrong with kids these days? You never see them having a good wholesome time at a bar like you used to.
Yeah, they changed the drinking age from 8 back to 18 a few years ago.
Did they? Man, that explains a lot. What gives with that?
The liquor company that bought Town Hall had to close after settling all those child endangerment cases.
You know what, Jay? I think everything was better when we were kids. I really mean that. What the hell kind of childhood is it if you can't go get a few beers with your best friend after school, right? Or, you know, during school, depending on the day. Wow, speaking of the old days, this place hasn't changed a bit, has it?
No, it hasn't, actually.
Look, our old seats are still open.
All of them are.
Don't be such a spoil sport, Jay. After all, today, I'm buying you a drink.
A drink? Seriously? From you?
I don't see anyone else here, do you?
Free drink from Mick Mercury. Now this I gotta see.
Two rings of Saturn, my man. Strong.
Don't do mixed drinks.
Alright. How do you like your whiskey, Jay?
With an active desire to do me harm.
I asked about your whiskey, not your men, but fine. I'll have what the lady's having.
Does he look familiar to you?
Yeah, they all look the same.
Fair. So, it sounds like you've got news for me.
Can't think of anything.
Oh, come on, you never buy drinks. You promise to, but it never quite works out that way. So what's different? One of your get-rich-quick schemes finally pan out?
Schemes? Come on, Jay, those aren't schemes. They're investments.
10 grids.
Can't beat Old Town prices. Even when you account for the gastrointestinal surgery, you still come out ahead.
I've got it. Put it on the card. See? Man of my word.
Thanks. So what happened? Your idea about roller skates for dogs take off?
Oh, I wish! Turns out the problem there isn't the skates, it's the dogs. They just spin in circles for a while and then start crying.
That sounds like someone else I know.
Come on, Jay. Forget the dogs. I don't want to talk about me. I'm fine. Me, I'm doing better than I have in years. I'm not worried about me. I'm worried about you, Juno.
Ha!
What's so funny?
I've been picking up your messes for almost 30 years and you're worried about me?
Hey, no reason to get so defensive.
Hey, who's defensive? I'm not defensive. I mean, what else am I supposed to do? You're worried about me? I found you sleeping underneath newspapers 3 times. I put you back on your feet more times than a skiing instructor on toddler day. One time, I had to stop you from actually eating your own hat just because you said you would, and you tell me I'm defensive? I am not defensive. I've got nothing to be defensive about.
I just mean, listen, Jay. I'm saying this as your friend.
Now here we go.
But when I called you last week, you sounded about as pepped up as a zombie on cold medicine. And today, Juno, man, you look like hell.
Oh, good. I thought you were going to say something I didn't already know.
What's going on, Juno? You haven't looked this bad since...
Cut it out,
when
Mick.
When we were kids and your brother...
I said drop it!
Oops.
I didn't mean your glass. Hey, bartender. Another glass for my friend here.
Got a couple of creds in it for you if you put some liquor in it, too. I got this one, man.
No. I said I was going to buy our drinks, so I'm going to buy our drinks. Bartender, put it all on this. Man, we had some fun times here, though, didn't we?
If you say so.
Why'd we stop coming here anyway?
Hard to go back to your old dive bar when everybody moves out of town.
Yeah, but we stopped coming here before then, didn't we? Yeah. Yeah, we used to love coming here. You, me, Sasha, and... Never mind. Let's drop it.
Good call.
Except, do you think... That wasn't the last day we came here, was it?
You've got a real habit of giving yourself good advice and then not following it, Mercury.
You're right. Forget I said anything. How long ago was that, anyway?
25 years ago today.
No way.
Thought that was why you asked me here, to be honest.
But that day was sometime in November, wasn't it?
It is November.
What? Seriously?
I don't usually joke about the month, Mick. Not much material there.
But how the... But my calendar said...
Your calendar? Oh, you're not still trying to make the crazy Martian calendar work, are you?
Mars has 23 months. 23! It doesn't make any sense to use the Earth calendar.
Well, people like the Earth calendar.
Why? You can't even pronounce half the names. What is a February even?
I don't know, but it sounds better than second month.
Well, sometimes I forget what number month it is when I'm filling out paperwork, and I'm just saying it'd be nice to... Oh, hey, is that Sasha?
Get your eyes checked, Mick. Sasha's with Dark Matters now. They don't bother with rat holes like Old Town.
Hey, Sasha, over here! We saved a seat for you.
Listen, lady, I'm sorry about my friend here. He's already had a few, and I think... Oh. Hey, Sasha.
Juno. Mick. It's been a while.
Sasha Wire. In the flesh. It had been 15 years since I'd seen her in person, but only a few months since we'd spoken. Back when Croesus Kanagawa croaked, she gave me a good tip and a bad contact. One of us definitely owed the other, but I didn't know which way the debt went. That's kind of how it goes with Sasha, though. She waits until the score is unsettled and then takes off for the stars. I don't blame her. She deserves them after what she's been through.
Funny coincidence. The past is really making itself known today.
What's that mean?
Don't bother. It's probably classified.
Not classified, just an observation. It was nice of you to save me a seat, Mick, but I think you may have overdone it a little.
Well, I couldn't remember which one was yours, so I saved them all. So, Sasha, what have you been up to lately?
Work, mostly.
Dark Matters, right? Must be a nice gig. Hey, do they pay well? Nice benefits?
They're all right.
Must be better than that if they let you take off a Tuesday to go grab drinks with your old friends.
I don't have the day off. I'm on NFE leave.
Oh, sounds fancy. What does that stand for, NFE?
Near Fatal Encounter. My subordinate tried to kill me.
Oh, okay.
It's nothing to be concerned about. Dark Matters is a vertically oriented organization that hires the quietest and deadliest the galaxy has to offer. Nearly every career ends either in termination or psychotic break. NFE leave is an institutional attempt to avoid the latter. Just standard procedure.
And I'll bet that institutional attempt is cheaper than sending agents off to be institutionalized, right?
Exactly.
So how's your attempted murderer looking?
My subordinate? Well, she brought a gun into my quarters and tried to kill me in my sleep. She missed my heart by a few inches, so I killed her in my sleep instead.
But why would someone...
Classified.
Really? Even to your best friends?
I'm afraid so.
She's up for a promotion.
Well.
Oh, come on. It's written all over your face.
No, it isn't.
Yeah, Jay. I'm not sure I've even seen Sasha's face make an expression. Ever.
What can I say? Master PI, I guess.
Well, if it's already out, yes, I am up for a promotion, and yes, my subordinate wanted it. Dark Matters agents have been killed over less. All I have to do is pass a psychological fitness test when my leave is up, and the position is mine.
Ooh, what job is it?
Classified.
Juno, what job is it?
I'm not even allowed to know.
Wow, I guess Dark Matters really likes their secrets.
Sure do. Hey, Mick, ask Sasha about the help she sent me on that Grimm's mask case. That was some top-notch communication.
What's he talking
Although
about?
Although it sometimes leads to inconveniences.
Inconveniences?
We've run the calculations and found that our security system's benefits outweigh its disadvantages. It's all for the greater good, as we say.
Oh, great you good.
Hey, I think that's enough shop talk for now, all right? Let me buy you a drink, Sasha. What's your poison these days?
Oolong.
Oh, that's sweet of you, Sasha. It has been too long.
It's tea, Mick.
Oh, sorry, never been too good with grammar. It's been tea long.
I can't listen to this anymore. Bartender, tea. Mick didn't tell me you were coming, Sasha.
There's a very good reason for that. He didn't know.
So you followed us here? Is that it?
I wish it were that simple, but no. I received an anonymous tip of the kind you don't turn down.
Anonymous, huh? What kind of tip?
I'd rather not say.
Classified?
Worse. Personal.
You don't say. Well, this is a coincidence then, isn't it? A very suspicious coincidence, but...
Suspicious? What? Why would it be suspicious?
I mean, nothing. It's probably just weird luck. Even if someone's trying to get you, Sasha, Mick and I have nothing to worry about, because it's not like anyone told him to bring me to this bar at this time today. Isn't that right, Mercury?
Absolutely. So weird. What a coincidence. Well, hey, I don't see why we have to look a gift horse in the mouth, right? We're not horse dentists. I mean, when have you ever even seen a horse? Okay, why are we talking about horses? You guys are weird. Anyway, drinks? Anyone need a refill? Yes? Yes? No? No? Yes? All right, I'll get one. Bartender...
Mercury, what the hell did you do?
Nothing! I didn't do anything!
Where'd all this money come from, then? How are you buying all these drinks?
I'm just being generous. Why is it so hard to believe I'd want to spend my hard-earned money on my old friends?
Because in order to spend hard-earned money, you need to have made hard-earned money ever.
Juno!
I'm not the one who takes his friend's charity and chews it up and spits it out all over his face like some kind of psycho bird mother jerk friend.
Maybe not, but you've been in debt up to your eyeballs ever since you were 10 years old, and I swear I've been waiting for the other shoe to drop ever since.
Other shoe? What other shoe? There's only one shoe.
So what is it then, Mick? You finally sell us out? You figure out that the price tag on your childhood friends comes out just about even to the sum of your debts?
What?
You heard me.
Sell you out? You really think I'd sell you out?
Yeah.
You want to know why I brought you here, Juno? Because I missed the old days. I just woke up one morning and I thought, man, things used to be so much easier. Back when it was me and Juno and Sasha and... Me and Juno and Sasha. I thought you always had someplace to be, someone to talk to. Even if you were hungry, at least you had some friends to be hungry with, you know? That's why I brought you here, to remember those times. All right?
All right.
And because I won a contest for an hour of free drinks here.
Look out, Sasha, there goes the shoe.
But it was mostly the first reason, really! Listen, I'm out of here. It was nice seeing you, Sasha. Give me a call sometime.
Good seeing you too, Mick. I'll call you, really. Juno, where did that come from?
Oh, I don't know.
Mick!
Sweet Shining Nebula, what was that?
Juno, get down! Mick, are you all right?
No!
Juno, disarm the bartender and I'll check on Mick.
I'd love to take his gun, Sasha.
Then do it!
But he's not holding one.
What are you babbling about?
If you don't believe me, take a peek over the bar. Try not to let him see too much of your head.
Juno, the bartender is a mechanical puppet, isn't he?
Looks like...
And there's a gun coming out of his mouth.
I mean, he could just have a weird tongue. I don't want to judge.
Take him down. I'll help Mick.
On it. Hey, Sasha, about taking the robo-tender down.
I'm over here. Attention would be nice.
You'll be fine, Mick. It looks like he just grazed you. Do you know what? What could you possibly mean?
I unloaded on him, but it didn't even leave a scratch. I don't know what this puppet's made of, but it ain't anything these lasers can touch.
But what are we supposed to do? Just wait for him to shoot again?
You see him shooting? If whoever put that thing here wanted us dead, we'd be dead.
Oh, because that's so reassuring.
Is this what it's like when you die? I'm not ready.
You're not dying, dammit. It's just a... lockdown siren.
Warning. Omega-class sandstorm detected. Likelihood of city shield breach at 54%. To prevent damage to other districts of Hyperion City, all routes into and out of Old Town will close until further notice. Thank you for your cooperation.
Trapped! We're trapped!
Damn it, leave it to Mick Mercury to plan a family reunion on the same day as the storm of the century.
I didn't know!
Well, you should have. All right, Sasha, I think it's about time you tell us why you're here. We're stuck in the incredible spitting bartender over there. Just made this all of our business, whether you like it or not.
Fine. I suppose you're right. Do you remember what day it is, Juno?
Tuesday.
The anniversary. Annie died 25 years ago today.
Right. But her body was never found. Do you remember that? The HCPD searched the factory up and down for weeks, and they never found a sign of her. Well, someone has. Claims to have, anyway.
Any evidence?
No.
That stinks worse than Mick, Sasha.
Hey.
Of course it does. In 99 cases out of 100, this was bound to be a trap.
Why walk into it, then? Annie is dead.
So you keep saying.
I keep saying it because it doesn't look like it's sticking.
Yes, Annie is almost certainly dead. Fine. But can you imagine what this is like for me, Juno? 25 years with no body. 25 years with no evidence. Not a single day out of the last 9,131 has gone by without a gleam of misspent hope that at any moment I might hear a knock and find my sister at the door. Like the last quarter of a century never happened. I need to know. I don't have a choice.
I got bad news for you, Sasha. A body is not going to make that hope go away. Trust me.
Guys. Guys, the bartender.
Sasha, help me!
Annie!
Sasha! Sasha, where are you? You were supposed to watch me. Mom's gonna be really mad. Sasha, please, I'm sorry. I won't bother you anymore. I'll stay home. I'll leave you alone. I just...
Mick, help me figure out how to turn this thing off. Now, damn it!
Sasha, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I won't do it again, I promise. I was wrong. Please help me.
What the hell?
I don't know.
He said he didn't do mixed drinks.
We just listened to that, and you're worried about the drinks?
Mick may have picked the right thing to worry about, Juno. It's the Skinner Supreme.
Condensed vodka, tequila syrup, bitter fruit. Ghost pepper?
You've got to be kidding me.
On the house.
Real generous of you, pal.
But why? Why is this happening again?
That day started just like this, didn't it? 25 years ago today.
We should have just let Annie follow us around. She wasn't doing anything wrong. If you want to follow us, you'll have to pass our 3 trials.
What did that thing just say?
I got one, guys. I got one. We'll make her drink the Skinner Supreme. Mick, that's just cruel. Well, if she wants it that bad, she'll do it. Besides, it'll be funny. Leave it to the King of the Freeway, guys. This is going to be great.
I didn't. No way. I couldn't have.
Now drink up, Annie.
Well, Mick, it looks like this round's on you after all.
I don't think. I think that maybe this is... Oh, I'm not a special agent. I'm not a PI. I was a security guard for a few hours once, but I locked myself out of the building and they fired me. I can't get tangled up in all this.
I'm sorry you did, Mick, but you did. And unless you want Bartender 5000 over here to give you a few exhaust ports, I'd recommend you come drink this thing with me.
You're going to drink that? How do you know it won't kill you?
He doesn't, but the bartender definitely will. Come on, Mick.
Oh.
Looks like you got what you wanted, Mercury. The old days still seem better.
Leave him alone, Juno. Things are bad enough already. Well, on the count of 3...
Oh.
Better take that as a yes, Sasha. Don't want to find out what happens if Pistol Mouth over there sneezes.
Well then. 1, 2, 3. How did we drink this? It's like sewer water.
Better than I remembered. Mick.
Oh,
Mick, come on, buddy. Snap out of it.
Oh, that's horrible.
I think that was the idea.
No, I don't mean the drink. I mean... Oh, did we really make somebody drink that?
Sasha, you're up next. I bet she's got something really good planned. Annie, are you still up for it? Of course I am. Well, all right. Let's get walking. We're going to Faust's Fun World.
Great service. Didn't even ask for a tip.
Fun World? But didn't they close that down years ago?
It doesn't matter. We're not going anywhere near it. I've walked into enough traps for one day. I'm calling in backup.
Good idea. I'll get Rita on the line. Damn, I can't get a signal through this sandstorm.
Neither can I.
So we're stranded.
Not yet. I have another communicator for situations like this. Old model, of limited use, but reliable. If we can bring it to a high enough altitude, I should be able to ping off of a satellite and contact Dark Matter's HQ directly.
How high an altitude are we talking?
The roof of any modern high-rise should do. 700 feet minimum.
Good luck. Old Town's not really known for being cutting edge, Sasha.
There. The Old Town Observation Deck. I don't recognize that name.
Me neither. Must be new.
It's the only option, but then I suppose we only need one. Mick.
What? If there's nobody behind the bar, then we might as well.
Come on, buddy. Put down the vodka, but take the glass with you. The way this day is going, you might need it. We didn't end up taking my car. You'd think after decades of crisis management, Old Town would have learned that as soon as you tell people they're locked in somewhere, they all head for the door. Traffic stretched out for miles, across five lanes and four vertical levels, all the way out to the far wall of the Old Town Shield. It'd probably take weeks to clear that bottleneck. We didn't stick around to find out. So we hoofed it to the observation deck, through old streets I never wanted to see again, and all the way that voice from the past kept ringing in my ears, Annie Wire from beyond the grave. The first in a long, long train of mistakes.
The observation deck must be just up ahead.
Guys, I think we've been this way before. I've been thinking about it, and that address sounds kind of familiar.
That... it can't be.
It is!
No way.
The fun world!
Listen, there comes a day in everyone's life when they figure out that what they're doing doesn't satisfy them anymore. Whether that thing is police work, banking, or their boyfriend, the day always comes when boredom starts knocking and we all wait to see if they're going to answer the door. For most of us, that means buying a dog. For the rich, it means philanthropy. Andrew Faust made his career out of selling big guns to people with short tempers, and when guilt grew in like a third nipple, he treated it like every other problem he'd ever had. He threw money at it until it went away. Not to anything useful, though. Not to schools or hospitals or libraries. He threw it all into this. Faust's fun world. Old Town's biggest problem, Faust said, was that all the kids were getting into trouble on the streets. So why not build a place for them where they could run and skip and play and chew cud or whatever it is kids do, free of charge? Faust was right about one thing. The fun world got kids off the streets. It was less wet and a lot easier to sell drugs indoors anyway.
Sasha, you said it wasn't the fun world.
It's not. It's supposed to be.
I thought they tore down Faust's years ago.
Well, apparently not. It looks as though they just stacked an observation deck on top of it.
Any way to cut corners, huh? Let's take a look. It should be worth a laugh. Really classed up the joint. Get a load of these statues.
Look at this. The Old Town Observation Deck is brought to you by the estate of Andrew Faust, with our sincerest apologies.
Oh man, guys. Oh man. Is this a surprise? Is that what's happening? Did you surprise me?
Sure, Mick. Thought I'd call up Solar Munitions and see if they could ring up a killer bartender for your birthday, too.
This is just like the time that my dad told me our dog got shot 15 times because he tried to stop a gang war. And once he got me out of the house, he brought me straight to Fun World.
That's quite a ruse just to get you to leave the house.
What? No, Wilco was dead. He got shot 15 times. Did I not say that? Anyway, this place was the best. The longest tube maze in the solar system. 100 miles of reinforced plastic tubing coiled in and around and up. This maze goes up three stories, guys.
Mick.
Three stories of fun, guys.
I hate to burst your bubble, but I don't think the fun world was as much fun as you remember.
Of course it was. One time I had so much fun in there, I wouldn't leave for 3 days.
You got lost. The HCPD had to send in a search party to find you.
What about all those scientists, then, who came by just to do experiments to see how Fun World fits so much fun in one building?
Those were shrinks, Mick. So many kids cracked inside the tubes that they decided it was cheaper to build a mental hospital next door than to gas up all those ambulances. Faust's Fun World. What the hell were you thinking, Sasha?
You think I don't regret it? I thought it was a good measure of wits. It was like a maze, and if you could make it to the top...
Nobody ever made it to the top.
I did. So did Annie.
Yeah, well, you two weren't like the rest of us.
Come on, guys, door's open and everything!
All right, let's do this.
Hold on, Juno. If this day is going to go this way, we should be prepared. We have a saying in Dark Matters.
Wearing sunglasses indoors isn't weird at all.
No.
Or how about, don't say anything clearly and no one can say you're wrong.
No, it's...
No, it's, loners get all the babes.
Are you finished?
I've got a few more in me, but you can go first.
Don't tell me about the knife at my throat until after you've pulled it away.
You all must be great at parties.
Whoever is doing this wants us to panic, and panic is contagious. We need to be very, very careful. If either you or Mick break, the rest of us won't be far behind.
I won't break.
I hope so. I'm trusting you with this, Juno. My mentor has told me that panic is the number one obstacle to survival in a crisis situation. We need to avoid it at all costs.
And this is the mentor who's going to bail us out of this mess.
He's the best there is.
You used to say that about me, Sasha. What happened?
I grew up.
Out. The elevator was out, which left only one way up. Fun World's famous tube maze. They boarded up that part of the building years ago, but no PI worth his pay ever let a blocked door stop him. The tube maze room looked like the kind of plumbing job you'd get if you hired a clown to fix your toilet. Multicolored pipes spiraling off in every direction as far as the eye could see. The tubes were smaller than Mick remembered, but big enough to crouch or crawl through. So we started crawling. And crawling. And crawling.
Oh, guys. I think I just remembered something.
Please, Mick. Share.
I hate tube mazes.
Yeah, you and everybody else.
They look so fun, though. And then you get inside, and it just smells like puke, and you can't see ahead of you, and you can't even stop moving without someone putting their face inside of your butt.
Keep crawling. We're nearly halfway there.
We've been crawling for an hour. I've got rug burn everywhere, from my ankles to my elbows.
Whose idea was
everywhere.
It?
Everywhere.
Whose idea was it to fill these stupid things with carpet anyway? That stink is awful.
Ugh, it is, isn't it? Oh, what is that?
It smells like... Oh, no.
I've smelled oh no before, Mick, and believe me, it smells worse than that.
The stories! Do you guys remember the stories kids used to tell? About... Oh, about what happens to the kids who get lost in these pipes? The kids who starve to death in here? They keep crawling, keep searching around for a way out forever. And if you found one, and you saw its pale face and its empty eye sockets...
Eye sockets? Did I miss something?
They chased you through the pipes so they could steal your eyes with their clammy little hands, and then you'd wander the pipes forever with them.
Mick, dear, you know all of that's impossible, don't you?
Yeah, well, if it's impossible, then how do you explain the girl? The girl who got lost in here and she saw something, and when she came out, she was so scared, her hair was white.
That's how all your stories end, Mick.
I'm serious, don't you remember? Nina Lou.
Nina Lou had a melanin deficiency, Mick. Her hair was always white.
Well, did she before she went in here? Do you know? Do you have evidence?
There are no eyeless children in these tubes. You made them up.
I did not.
You did. We were there. We did it to scare Annie.
I wouldn't do that. Would I? That's awful.
Yeah. Well, so were we.
Oh, but no monsters then, right?
No.
Then, I guess there's nothing to worry about. Nothing at all. We're just stuck tighter than sardines in a dark place where there's nowhere to run, and in a town where someone wants to kill us is all. What is that? That's not scary. We're the scariest things in here. Don't let them take my eyes!
What the hell was that?
Eyeless baby monsters. Just looking at one's a good way to lose every marble you've got, guys. We have got to go. We have got to go.
You only got one marble, Mick. Now just hold on to it. Sasha, plan?
I'm working on one.
All right, Mick's gone. Just you and me.
Find a way to keep him quiet. I'm trying to think.
Cool it, buddy. We're gonna get you out of here.
In how many pieces, Juno? How many? My dad's gonna want an open casket funeral because he's got the religion real bad. Then I don't know if I can disappoint him, even if I am dead.
Open casket? No, you never had a shot at that to begin with. Funeral director's gonna take one look at your ugly mug and cremate you twice just to make sure nobody ever has to look at it again.
Juno!
You told me to calm him down, I'm calming him down. Come on, Mick, you don't die here and we both know it.
We do?
Yeah. I've known since the day I met you that you die surrounded by beautiful women
with
baseball bats and 10 good reasons to kill you. Each.
We have fun, don't we, Jack?
Call it whatever you want, but we definitely have something. Now quiet, Mommy's working.
Do you hear that? Whatever's making that noise is right on top of us.
It's invisible?
Move! Now!
What the hell was that?
It's not in the tube with us, it's crawling on top!
And stabbing through?
Yeah, that seems to be the idea, yes. Stop!
Well, what now, Sasha? They cover situations like this at Dark Matter's sleepaway camp?
There's no such thing and you know it!
Well, we're not gonna crawl another mile through these tubes with that thing after us.
Do something about it then!
Fine, don't mind if I do.
Did you get it, Jay?
Ow! I think like you may have missed.
Miss? Sorry, Sasha, I think you're confused. I don't miss.
Listen to how quickly it's moving, Juno. It's just not possible for you to hit it.
Don't tell me what I can't hit.
What are you going to do? You have to stop it.
Well, hold it in place and maybe I will.
Mick!
Get her out, get her out, get her out!
Hold Mick still so I can get that thing spiked out like, Juno.
In a sec. Sorry, Mick, just hold that monster in place a little longer.
What are you talking about?
Got it.
It hurts. It hurts.
Hold still, Mick. We'll take care of it.
Oh, that looks awful.
Juno, not helping. Panic, remember?
Panic? Who's panicking? Is there something to panic about? Am I going to die? I'm going to die, aren't I? This is it. I can feel it happening. Oh, there's a light at the end of the tunnel. This is it. This is it.
That's an actual light at the end of an actual tunnel, you moron. We're almost out of the maze. Sasha, shouldn't we go find what that thing was?
There's a time and place for everything, Juno. If it isn't trying to kill us right now, then it can wait.
Another one of your fancy dark matter sayings?
No, it's just common sense.
Ah, must be why I've never heard of it. We had to drag Mick the rest of the way, which was terrible for both my back and my eardrums.
Juno, I need you to hold Mick still while I get the shot ready.
Shot? What shot? I don't need a shot, please. Not like Wilco. Not like Wilco.
Wilco?
It was his damn dog. Give him the shot.
No!
Sasha splinted and bandaged Mick enough ways to make a mummy feel underdressed. She was quick and efficient.
Hey!
And so was the shot.
Hey, that feels all right.
You're lucky the spike missed your bone. You should be fine, so long as you don't overexert yourself.
You guys are the best, you know that. We got Juno taking all those shots at that thing. Pew, pew, pew! And Sasha with all her crazy dark matters, gadgets and gadgets, and... I have the coolest friends.
Good thing we can say the same, buddy.
Oh, you're just saying that to be nice.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, you guys!
Half an hour passed while Sasha fooled around with her communicator and I kept Mick under control. Well, tried to.
So, Jay, buddy, you never answered my question earlier.
You have kind of a lot of questions, Mick. You're going to have to refresh my memory.
Like, how are you, you know?
Oh, not this again.
It's just real hard to tell with you. Like, you never really talk about yourself. Ever since we were kids, right?
Seriously? Hi, we must not have met before. My name is Juno Steel. People say I let my mouth get away from me so often that they named a leash law after me.
Maybe now, sure, but not when we were kids. It used to be that the only way anyone knew you were mad at them was if you'd broken a few of their teeth. You'd just sit on something really quiet for hours or days or weeks, and suddenly I'd be on the floor wondering how I was going to explain my fifth concussion to my dad.
I did that to you?
I mean, not as much as other people did, but yeah.
Wow. Hey, look, Mick.
Mick! Juno, get over here. I think I found something.
Coming, Mom.
The signal's gone through. We should be in contact with Agent Burgess any second now.
Who?
My mentor. He'll know what to do. He's probably lived through 100 days like this. Got him. Agent Burgess. Sir, it's Agent W. Yes, I'm on the SATCOM you gave me. No, we've been given no notice about the state of the lockdown. Have you heard anything about the sandstorm?
What's he saying?
Nothing reported to the public.
Probably good, right?
That's to the public. Internally, he says they're arguing about whether there's a letter that comes after Omega.
We didn't climb all the way up this stupid tower for a weather report, Sasha. Are we getting back up or not?
Sorry, Agent Burgess. Tensions are high here. What's the... just a panicked civilian.
A what?
Regardless of the situation with the storm, sir, we need backup. Whoever's pinned us here is heavily armed, and they know us well. Recordings, personally charged messages... Yes. I know all launches and landings are suspended in a sandstorm of this magnitude, Agent Burgess. Yes. Yes, I know. But someone... Yes, right. But we have an injured civilian here, sir. Someone's after us, and these messages... No, I won't lose my head, sir. I know the risks. No backup, Agent Burgess. We're going to die up here.
Not yet, we won't.
Yeah, you hear that, Sasha? We can still get out of this. We're not going to die. Juno said so.
Not yet, I said. One trial left, after all.
Not... Oh, you don't mean the factory. I'm not going in that factory, Juno. Not after... Do you know what they keep in there?
I don't want to hear about it.
Sir, what's that? You're breaking up, sir. Sir? Who is this?
Who's what? Where?
Sasha, what is going on?
I think you'd better listen to this.
You passed the second trial! I hope you made it through okay. I hear there are monsters in those tubes. Mean kids who grab their sister's legs and sprain their little sister's ankles.
What?
Do you think... my leg... Juno, did you really stop that
thing? I feel like I'm in those tubes, you know? It's like a nightmare. A nightmare I've been alone in for 25 whole years. Alone until today.
Make it stop!
Come on, guys! It's been so long since we played together. We only get one day, and that day will be over so soon. Please, Sasha, Mick, Juno, come find me. You know where I am. I'm still where you killed me 25 years ago.
The factory.
Over there, guys, look. The lights. Why are the lights all flashing over there? There aren't supposed to be any lights, are there? It's been abandoned for years! Jay? Juno? Juno!
I missed you so much! I can't wait to see you again.
Sasha, Jay, what do we do? We're not going there, are we?
And walk straight into a trap? Of course not! We need backup. We'll wait as long as necessary to get it.
But she'll find us, won't she? Annie's gonna find
us. Stop it!
We're not hanging around here.
But...
and we're not going to the damn factory either. Hyperion blocks off every route they can when a sandstorm blows through, but there's one connection so important that not even they would block it off.
Juno, you really think we can make it out?
Of course I do. Hope you brought your galoshes. We're liable to get pretty soggy before the day is out. A 25-year nightmare, Annie said. Well, I had some experience with those. The worst kind of nightmares are like carnival barkers, dragging out every dark memory and putting it on a pedestal and shouting at you, step right up, we've got mistakes, we've got guilt, we've got every time you hurt someone, every time someone died because you weren't good enough. Come one, come all, and see the incredible defective detective try and escape what's coming to him. Make as many mistakes as I do, you have a lot of nightmares like that. But Annie, this day, all those years ago, this was a bad one. And it all ended there. The Old Town Munitions Factory, flickering in the distance, reanimated after nearly a century in the dark. If the stories were right, then at the start of the war, it had spit out nightmares across the galaxy, the kind that a civilization never really wakes from. And I'd never woken from the nightmare that had started for me either. I knew how this day was going to end. The same way it did last time at the Old Town Munitions Factory where I killed Annie Wire.
The tale you've just heard, part one of Juno Steel and the Day That Wouldn't Die, was told by the following people: Joshua Elon as Juno Steel, Kate Jones as Rita, Stefano Purdy as Mick Mercury, Sophie Kaner as Sasha Wire, Mia DeLuvio as Annie Wire, and Tara Faella and Kevin Vibert as the ensemble. On staff at the Penumbra, Kevin Vibert is our lead writer and recording engineer. Sophie Kaner is our director and sound designer. Graham Turner is our lead editor. Juno's theme was written by Ryan Vibert. The Penumbra is created and produced by Sophie Kaner and Kevin Vibert. I'm so sorry you've been called away, dear traveler. We eagerly await your return.